On July 6, 2021, Nintendo announced a new entry into the series of Nintendo Switch systems for a surprise video drop on their social channels, with this video introducing a brand new model of the Nintendo Switch, the Nintendo Switch OLED model, with that OLED model part being in brackets of the system's actual name. Yeah, it doesn't really appeal well in simplicity of naming schemes. System names aside, the video introduced a few new features that differ from the original model, with two bigger factors from the get-go are the new variation in Joy-Cons changing from black to white, and the 7-inch widescreen on the tablet, with other features including the better speakers, a wider more secure kickstand on the back, and a new dock that features a built-in LAN port. While simple on paper, these features have some net positives to a range of audiences that are actually pretty good upgrades to the system, with the 7-inch OLED screen allowing for a clear image while playing games, the kickstand being more secure and adjustable, and the built-in LAN port means that more money isn't required to use on older hardware for people who want a more stable, wired connection. And with the upgraded system being about a 30-50 price increase in comparison to the original counterpart, in my eyes, it's a pretty decent price all things considered, especially with the certain hardware upgrades and changes. However, the reception to the announcement was fairly mixed, with a variety of comments saying that the upgrades are cheap and not sustainable to sales, with comparisons being made as to how it can't stack up well in the modern console market. And while these are fair comments to make and think about, when mentioning that, you have to keep in mind certain aspects when it comes to Nintendo's history of console revisions. But before we talk about some of the negatives, let's look into more of the positives behind this. Let's look into these changes and compare them to the original model of the system, and come to a conclusion on if these are substantial changes or not. Color scheme. It's white. It's a nice fresh contrast in comparison to the older model with the all black and neon. A neon OLED exists as well. I myself put the neon model because the extra colors to the Joy-Cons gives me the vibrancy to it that makes it stick out as a Nintendo based console. Although this time I'll definitely get the white one because it looks clean, and I do not want another pair of neon Joy-Cons. However, a downside to having a new system be more bright is the higher chance of having stains and marks be more visible, which can definitely ruin the clean aesthetic of the system in something like a living room. Next, the screen. 7 inches! An 0.8 increase on the new type of screen. In case you might be unaware, the regular Switch uses an LCD screen. But the way this differs from an OLED is that the LCD screens have a backlight to make the visuals properly visible. With an OLED screen, each pixel emits light allowing for vivid colours and high contrast. And also in Nintendo's words on their website, deep blacks can be represented by turning a pixel's light off, allowing for higher contrast. In simpler terms, the screen is bigger and better. Next up, the kickstand. This time being wider and fitting to the console's lengths and being more sturdy, especially with the flexibility of angles you can adjust it to. Honestly, this is hands down probably one of the best changes made to the system for a lot of people. Like, look at the shitty kickstand the old system had. Enhanced audio. Well, in this case, it's gonna be hard to compare. So, let's just say the audio is definitely much more immersive with the actions you do in-game. New dock. Definitely like the more clean and streamlined look of it, but the smoothed out edges and the branding to be more shiny. It's kinda nice. Also, holy shit, no, 2-3 footage. No. With this new dock also comes a built-in LAN port. Oh my god, yes. You have no idea how much pain it caused for people just to go out of their way to buy an extra outdated peripheral just for a smooth connection. Like the Xbox One has one straight from the get-go. Honestly, I would do this, but that would mean I have to drill a hole through the ceiling just for that. Yeah, I live the hard life. Also, wouldn't really mean much when I get speeds like this. Like, what the fuck is this? Also, did I notice the Switch logo or the dock light up or something? And that's about it, really. Nothing else in the trailer mentioned anything that might be of interest. The website says you can get 64GB of internal storage, which is more than the original's 32GB. But aside that, there are no changes to anything majorly internal. Same specifications in comparison to the older model, so what gives? What about these Bloomberg reports that said we would be getting 4K and DLSS and stuff like that? First of all, snap out of it. Secondly, this is Nintendo we're talking about. It would be a goddamn miracle for them to make advances on their consoles to meet the specs to something like a PlayStation 4. Like, think about this realistically. This is kinda a Nintendo move. I think of the 3DS. It had a re-release later on in its lifetime to add extra features and implement changes to improve the user experience. This is pretty much what the OLED model is in a nutshell. And yes, I agree, it would be nice to see Nintendo take a move to something like 4K, DLSS, or RGB, or whatever we want from the modern experience. But hey, at least it moved the position of its brightness sensor. Right? Man, I hope the next Nintendo console allows me to have sex. Now, this comes to the ultimate conclusion. Will I be getting this OLED model? Yeah, why not? To be honest, I prefer playing the thing in handheld due to the simplicity of picking it up and playing it anywhere. And with the OLED model, I'll definitely feel like my experience is going to be improved with the new additions to the system. And I don't know, I'll probably mod my old system somehow so it still has a purpose. Till then, I'll wait for its release and save up to get it alongside Metroid Dread. Only because I'm obligated to do so.
Finally, another Metroid game I'll like but never buy.
Yeah, but like, I called it, so now you have to buy it.
I have to buy it now, I'm sorry.
But when I do get it, I'll be able to make the long-awaited video of was getting the Switch OLED model a worthwhile experience? And the short answer to that will probably be no. Many thanks to the supporters on Ko-fi, who helped me continue to do this type of content. This time, I would like to give a special thanks to Bellyman with a £50 donation, commenting, "Unscrews your birthday," and to Fabulio with a £5 donation, commenting, "IsaacPog.jpg."